the hospital came to me and they wanted me to paint a mural about marine life that was 25 feet high. And the marine life part wasn't at all tricky, but the 25 feet high part and figuring out how to get up there and not kind of fall off the scaffolding was a little bit trickier. I have a mentorship going on with two great kids from the high school, Caleb Gray and Chris Pitt. Chris Pitt's doing a photo documentary and Caleb Gray is my fill-in guy. So both are just a wonderful source of energy and happiness in the project. It's been a blast the whole way along. I mean, just painting the swordfish's face, I had no idea what was going to happen. I thought, I hope this works. First I have my really tight drawing and then I paint the background, and so there's these layers of color that I build everything forward from. And then I begin to chalk in my design. Some areas like the swordfish where I have a lot of foreshortening and it's so large, I relied on grid work. In other places I just eyeballed it, and the design has kind of morphed as I've been working on it. The fun challenge in a real mural is that kinetic piece, that the way that we flow with a mural and follow it and experience it dimensionally. And in this case, it's not just the flow. It's looking up from underneath and looking down from up above. So the perspective that I have to consider of looking at fish's bellies, and what does it feel like to be under the water versus rising up and into the sky? This is the kind of stuff that just revs my jets. I've been making murals for 32 years now. I did 90 feet of mural for the Arkansas Children's Hospital with an all-sculpted foreground. And I've done work for Central DuPage Hospital and a daytime recovery center for homeless people in New Orleans. I've done many businesses here on the island. I've painted everything that can be possibly painted. Mural painting is not just my only vocation. I'm also a painter and an illustrator and author. And I'm probably best known for my mermaids. I think that my work has a soul in it, or a piece of my soul in it, that people can experience. I see people here daily that it's painful for them to walk, but they'll walk to that window to see what I've done that day, to kind of stay abreast of the project. I have rolled invalids here in wheelchairs daily. I get to see little kids try to figure out how on earth somebody can paint something that big. When I do a mural, I've now gotten to see how many people get to enjoy something like this, and to project that into years to come is very gratifying.